Welcome to this lecture, our last lecture. We rendered this here in Revit. Do Revit rendering. So you can render as many views as you want. So you can rotate it. To rotate the way I'm rotating, and hold your shift and your middle button. And rotate. Hold your shift and middle button. Rotate it any side you want. Or connected, you can come here. This is basic. So now we are going to link, synchronize this work to Lumia and see how. So it's processing. For sake of time, we will now pause a bit and okay, skip. Wait, let's wait for it. My computer is low. Higher system configuration, at least 16 gigs RAM. This is Lumia. Thank you. Basically, these are the shortcuts that you need. QE, S, height, movement keys, WA, moving left, right, space for slow speed, shift for high speed, shift and space for higher speed. Then other ones, I click O. If you don't want to use this synchronize method that we use, then we also have from here, this is the imported model, and imported this model that is here. Then here you have nature, numerous nature, materials, plants, trees. The window has a lot of trees. So for, because my system is slow, I will not be able to load a lot of trees. It will heavy the system more. So just render it the way it is. Apply materials on this. So you go to this imported model. So here now you can this nature. Here you have trees, flowers, you can get a nature. Fine details, the most more advanced HD plantings. Find them in these people. These are effects. So, look at the material. Materials, you see, you want to change this material or something else, click on it. See, the name that we name in Revit is in a wall upper, that was the name we gave it in Revit. So, this has come, so you have different level of materials outdoor. So, you want to pick anyone you want, is it outdoor, is it brick? See what you want. up. So you select what let's say we're comfortable with this. Let's say we're happy with this. We want this to be for speed together. This is basically a demonstration, so I'm not necessarily get a choice of color combinations. And so you want this, you want to go with this. So you want to go with this now, you want to upgrade it. So this has been accepted, this material has been accepted. So you put another material, say like this fence. You want to give fence another color, okay? This fence and the wall is the same, but that's what I'm saying. You have to go up to Revit and split it. Otherwise, any change you make here, it will affect all, which I don't want. So, we'll come to this cap, select this cap, this material we put on the cap. So on the cap you have various outdoor. And cancel that. One place I want to put is glass. Select glass, change color the glass. As you can see in Revit, you are able to see through the glass, you see what is happening inside. So this is glass. Different colors in the glass. You can pick that. And glass with that. I want glass to be blue. So I'm going to have something like this. Yeah. So we can have something like this. Accept it. So this glass, you can still make some adjustment on it. And make adjustment. You want colorization or colorization. And you can see it. Reflectivity. Transparency. Mm-hmm. So you can make some changes, you can make some adjustments based on what you have. Now you are done, you can okay. So this is how you basically apply material. You pick anyone, your roof, give material in your roof, it's outdoor. So this is basically what we have. Let's place some object. Let's place some few nature. Let's plant things. Have some few ones and place it. So we can have some plant trees outside. Plantings we put in Revit, it's not found. Pick something. So or not put much of the planting because of this is supposed to be higher, see? Graphics card low, and graphics card are low. So, no load much of the trees. When I go to use my office system, and I'm now able to explore a lot of things you need to know about Roman. So let me just put some front tips. So, once you place it, you can scale it. So, scale it. This we can put some trees. Thank you. Satisfied with this, and I can go to my photos. I have a custom template. You can pick realistic. Graphics card, so let's see, have this face camera. When you get the particular view you want in this box, click on it, pick your camera. So you can still go. Second camera snap. Okay. So do that. So get as many views as you want. Capture from a distance like this. Capture this as I'm with my office system is a bit higher than my laptop. And I'm able to demonstrate better how you can use Lumia and apply, add a lot of things to Lumia environment. So my environment is empty because I don't want to overload it. So this is how basically render Lumia, no doubt it gives a better quality clarity, as you can see. I compare this with what you rendered in Revit. See the difference. So we are left with 20 seconds remaining. 10 seconds, 13 seconds remaining. Okay. So rendering is now complete. So we can open folder to see where the photos are saved. This is it. So here, I forgot to select photo set. It's only one that is rendered. So you can select the option photo set, and all the photos that you snap, one will be rendered. But since I didn't select, it's only one. It's the same process. So thank you all, and watch out for more detail, other details, tutorials. Thank you.